an annual celebration for the Hare Krishnas outside Almaty. But this could be their last feast here. The Krishna Society no longer owns this land, and their farmhouse temple is awaiting the bulldozers. Their future is uncertain.
From one side, it's a bit of hopeless. It's like hanging in the air without ground to stand upon. But simultaneously, you know, we are faithful people. So we've got God inside our heart, and you can bulldoze your faith.
Kazakhstan's Hare Krishnas began developing this community back in 1999 when they purchased land and buildings. But their activities drew the attention of the local authorities. Since 2003, they've faced numerous court actions disputing ownership of the land and their right to worship there. Rulings resulted in many of their homes being demolished and the farmland confiscated. Final proceedings will decide the fate of the temple over the coming weeks. The Hare Krishnas allege discrimination on the basis of their faith. Human rights groups cite a number of other minority faiths that are experiencing state interference in Kazakhstan. They fear new draft legislation, which could ban unapproved religious organizations altogether.
It is the system which do not like free people. It tried to control all public activities. No matter it is the political activity of the political parties, social activity of the civil society groups, or religious groups.
The local authorities insist this has nothing to do with politics, and they are only enforcing the law.
This is not an issue of obstructing their rights, this is an issue of respecting the law. In order to make the members of the Krishna Society leave the illegally occupied land, we've given them land in the Talgar region, so their requests have been fulfilled.
This is what they've been offered in return, a handful of acres of wasteland in exchange for the 100 acres or so of farmland that they've lost.
Whether this is a dispute about property or a crackdown on religious minorities is debatable. Either way, moving along the Hare Krishnas may do little to enhance the image of tolerance that Kazakhstan wants to project to the world. Robin Forestier Walker, Al Jazeera, Almaty.
Well, joining us now for more on this situation in Kazakhstan is Dag Nigar of the Oslo Coalition of Freedom of Religion and Belief. Mr. Nigar, thanks very much indeed for joining us. It's interesting, this is not presenting a tolerant image of a country just about to assume a role advocating the rights of people.
Yes, and that has been protested against among many human rights organizations over the world. This is not only a problem for the Kazakhstan as the chair of OSCE, but I think it also is will be a problem for the whole organization of OSCE, and it could be the start of the failure of OSCE.
How do you view the legislation that's currently going through parliament in Kazakhstan right now that may actually end up banning minority faiths altogether?
It is very difficult to have a fully overview of this legislation because this is a closed process. It is difficult to have details on the different proposals and the amendments made to this legislation. And that is to be criticized. But the reactions from those who have insights in the proposals are heavy, and also the members of the expert panel of OSCE that has have joined the parliament in this process are very critical. Have made critical points to the proposals, but those proposals or those remarks from OSCE expert panel has been rejected by Kazakhstan authorities.
All right, Dagnygar, we'll leave it there. Many thanks indeed for your perspective on this. Thanks a lot.